Hey everyone, good morning, good evening, good afternoon, however and wherever you're tuning in from. James Dow, back here with another knife review. Today we're going to be checking out a knife I got from my father for Father's Day. I gave it to him a bit early, me and my brother did. This is Bestechman, at least that's how I say it. Desert Warrior, OD green with a copper blade. It's a button lock knife right there. It has all black hardware. G10 handles. It has a deep, at least I believe that's a deep pocket carry clip, you know, pocket clip. It's reversible. You can flip it to the other side. There is a hole for a lanyard. There'll be a thinner one, you know, nothing too thick. The blade on it has laser engraved right there. Bestechman. While we're looking at this side, you can see the G10 handle scales, or the handles, we'll call them. They're textured. They got some nice grooves in them. They give a lot of grip. Good jimping on the back. I don't know if that's what you call that, but great texture. But you definitely have some good jimping up here. Bit dirty, you know. My dad wasn't the nicest to it. He really uses his blades, and that's fine by me. It was lost for a little bit, and that, you know, it's like, oh, man, whatever. But it came up, it showed up, and I knew it would. It's a button lock blade, but you don't need to press the button lock to open this knife. To open it, all you do is just pop the detent, you know, you just flick it. It is a manual opener. Let me zoom you all out just a fuzzy right here. It's a manual opener. Beautiful blade, copper blade. It says Bestechman right there. On the other side, it says Keanu, for after the designer who designed this blade. I don't know his last name. Sorry about that. I'll have to add that to the description below. But just a great knife. Very, very well balanced. Great size. Feels very nice in the hand. Fits right. No hot spots anywhere. To close it, you just press the button. The blade drops. Over there, like Big E over there, Eli, Big E's knives, straight down Broadway for the most part. I'm trying to get it straight with the camera, but like you can see, ain't touching nothing. Might be a little bit more to this side, but also might just be the way I'm showing it, because it's straight right there. I love how he always shows that off. I'm always looking at knives now because of that right there, Big E, and I appreciate that. When I got this knife, it was, you know, it popped some hairs on you. Now it ain't as sharp. We'll bring it over here to the old rope. Starting to do that with more knives. Get a good little wrap around right here. There we go. So it's all safe. Don't want it's too much. Start from the sharp edge, right? Like you should. Pulling away from it. And that's pretty sharp right there. I haven't honed it. I haven't done nothing on the old leather. Got it back from my dad, used it for a few days. Been meaning to do this video, but before I shoot my videos, I like to carry my knives, see how they act, all that, you know. I do enjoy this little choil right here. I don't place my finger around there. Keep my fingers right around here when I'm using it. But just really nice for sharpening and getting in there. Thumb studs work great. It closes quick, simple, one-handed action. As you saw, it opened. I didn't even have to press that. Just wants to drop close. Very nice. Just very nice. Wants to jump out on you. Just a well-made knife, to be honest with you. Take it over here to the old ruler right quick. Get a little measurement on it closed up. It's looking about 4.5 inches right there. Take a measurement. Sometimes it helps layer down that way. Going to be looking at a blade length. Oh, I was going for the total at first, then I started to say the blade length. What a goofy. All right, here we go. 3.5 inch blade. And we're looking at about a... Get all that on camera for y'all. Trying my darndest right here. I'll just tell you it's an 8-inch overall blade length. And yeah, very, very practical for the carry. Nothing too heavy. I got it for about $30. On sale. I think these run you normally around 60 or 80 bucks, 70 maybe. Around that range. Don't hold me to it, but just great value. Is made in China. So it's one of my more, you know, knives I can be a bit rougher on. Ain't like the Kershaw over there, but Yeah, you know, I really enjoy carrying this knife. You know, I've enjoyed it. I don't got nothing bad to say. That's the thing I'm thinking about. Anything I don't enjoy about it, there's nothing. D2 steel is really impressive right there. Almost forgot to show that off, but yeah, it says it right there, the greatest steel, D2. My dad, he scuffed it up right there, but happy to see that, you know. He really has been using it. But yeah. On that note, I appreciate everyone tuning in, checking out this video. Until next time.